أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم.
الحمد لله. الحمد لله الذي امتن على عباده بنبي المرسل صلى الله عليه وسلم وكتابه المنزل حتى تسعى على أهل الأفكار طريق الاعتبار بما فيه من القصص والأخبار وتدح به سلوك المنهج القويم والصراط المستقيم بما فصل فيه من الأحكام وفرق بين حلال والحرام. ونشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، ونشهد أن سيدنا ونبينا ومولانا محمد عبده ورسوله صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وأصحابه الذي تذكروا بالقرآن وذكروا به الناس تذكيرا. أما بعد، فقد قال الله سبحانه وتعالى في القرآن المجيد والفرقان الحميد بعد: أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم، بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. يا أيها قل يا عبادي الذين أسرفوا على أنفسهم لا تقنطوا من رحمة الله. وقال: يا أيها الإنسان ما غرك بربك الكريم ففروا إلى الله. وقال عليه الصلاة والسلام: الكيس من دان نفسه وعمل لما بعد الموت، والآجز من أتبع نفسه هواها وتمنى على الله. وقال عز وجل: يا أيها الذين آمنوا توبوا إلى الله، توبوا إلى الله توبة نصوحة. الحمد لله. My dear respected brothers and elders, beloved sisters in Islam, Allah is Khaliq. Besides Allah, everything is makhluk. Allah is the creator, and besides Allah, everything was created by one Allah. Allah is Ghani. Allah is rich and independent. And besides Allah, the entire creation is fakir. We all fuqara. We're dependent, we're beggars, we're dependent on one Allah and one Allah alone. Allah is Qawiyul Aziz. Allah is mighty, powerful. Besides Allah, there is no other power. Nothing has the ability to move and to stop moving. No one has the ability to benefit another without the permission and the qadr of one Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala put forward himself in Quran, questioning insan. Alam ta'alam. Allah is saying, O insan, alam ta'alam. Are you not aware? Do you not know? Anna Allaha ala kulli shay'in qadir. Ulama and mufassirin, they explain shay. What is shay? Shay is everything besides Allah. And anna Allah ala kulli shay'in qadir. That Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has power over each and everything. Not insan and the technology of insan. Not the trees and the branches and the leaves of the trees. Not the winds and its roaring speeds. Not the clouds and the drop of rains, millions of drop of rains in these clouds. Not the heavens, my dear respected brothers. Not the first heaven, not the inhabitants of the first heaven. Not the second heaven and the inhabitants of the second heaven. Not the third heaven and the inhabitants of the third heaven. Not the fourth, not the fifth, not the sixth, not the seventh heaven. Not Jibreel alayhi salatu wasalam, not the angel that are carrying the arsh of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has any power to move, to benefit, to stop moving. Those things that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has brought into existence cannot cease themselves from existing. Those things that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala never brought into existence cannot come into the existence without the order, without the command of one Allah and one Allah alone, my dear respected brothers. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has brought this entire creation into existence. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala receives the entire creation from existing. Quran bear testimony to this, my dear respected brothers. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, Kullu man alayha fan wa yabqa wajhu rabbika dhul jalali wal ikram. Each and everything will be destroyed. Each and everything will come to an end. And what will remain is Allah, Allah, and the greatness of Allah, Allah, and everything of Allah, my dear respected brothers. Everything will be destroyed. Dear respected brothers, and then our standing is before Allah. On the day of judgment, my dear respected brothers, when everything is destroyed, when everything has been destroyed, Israfil, Malikul Maut, the angel of death, will come to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, though Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala knows the condition of the heavens and the earth, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will ask Malikul Maut, who is it that remained? Who is it that remained? Malikul Maut, Israel, will say, it is I that remained. It is Jibreel alayhi salatu wasalam that remained. It is Israfil alayhi salatu wasalam that remained. It is Mikael alayhi salatu wasalam that remained. It is the four angels that are carrying the arsh of Allah that remains. And it is Allah that remains. Nothing else remains. This is the reply of Israfil alayhi salatu wasalam. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will command Israfil, let death come to Jibreel alayhi salatu wasalam. Let death come to Mikael alayhi salatu wasalam. Let death come to Israfil alayhi salatu wasalam. Let death come to the four angels that are carrying the arsh of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And this order of Allah will be carried out. Again, Malikul Maut comes to Allah. Then Allah will ask him again, who remains? Who remains? Malikul Maut will say, it is I that remain, it is Allah that remain, everything else is dead. Malikul Maut, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will command Malikul Maut, Israel alayhi salatu wasalam, to take his own soul. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will say, my dear respected brothers, Limanil mulkul yawm, for who is this day? Where are the rulers? Where are the so-called emperors? Where are they? لِمَنِ الْمُلْكُ الْيَوْمِ No one is there to answer beside Allah. What Allah will say, لِلَّهِ الْوَاحِدِ الْقَهَارِ In the following ayat, my dear respected brothers, Allah says, الْيَوْمَ تُجْزَى كُلُّ نَفْسٍ بِمَا كَسَبَتْ That each and every soul will be taken to task. Each and every soul will have to give an account for each and every action in this world. Allah continues to say, La dhulm al yawm. No one will be wrong on that day. Each and every one will have to give the responsibility, give an account for each and every action in this world, my dear respected brothers. So, my dear respected brothers, our standing before Allah is definite. Our standing before Allah is definite. Nevertheless, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala created this insan, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala created this insan for one purpose and one purpose alone. وَمَا خَلَقَتُ الْجِنَّ وَالْإِنسَ إِلَّا لِيَعْبُدُونَ Ulama explains, إِلَّا لِيَعْرِفُونَ That we recognize who is Allah, we recognize the qadr of Allah, we recognize the mercy of Allah, we recognize the rahmat of Allah. This is the purpose of our creation, my dear respected brothers. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has elevated this insan above each and all creation. Each, from the inception of insan, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala made this clear that insan has been elevated over the entire creation. وَلَقَدْ خَلَقَنَاكُمْ ثُمَّ صَوَّرْنَاكُمْ وَكُلْنَا لِلْمَلَائِكَةِ اسْجُدُوا لِآدَمَ فَسَجَدُوا إِلَّا إِبْلِيسِ Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, we created you, we fashioned you, then we command the angels to prostrate. Elevation upon elevation, my dear respected brothers. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, Allahu alladhi khalaqa as-samawati wal-ard wa anzala min as-samai ma'a fa akhraja bihi min ath-thamarati rizqan lakum. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, I created the skies, I created the heavens and the earth, and from the skies we send forth rain, and from the rain come the provision for insan. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala continues to say, وَسَخَّرَ لَكُمُ الْفُلْكَ لِتَجْرِي فِي الْبَحْرِ بِأَمْرِي وَسَخَّرَ لَكُمُ الْأَنْهَارِ, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has made the ocean subjects to insan, that they may sail with the ships across this ocean. وَسَخَّرَ لَكُمُ الْأَنْهَارِ, and we've made the rivers also the same. All subjects for mankind. وَسَخَّرَ لَكُمُ الشَّمْسَ وَالْقَمْرَ دَائِبَيْنِ, all for mankind. وَسَخَّرَ لَكُمُ اللَّيْلَ وَالنَّهَارِ, night and day for mankind. This entire universe were created for the benefit and the comfort of mankind, but mankind was created illa liya'budun, for the worship and the ibadat of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala continues to say, wa ataakum min kulli ma sa'altumu, that this insan, we've given each and everything that they ask of us. Everything Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave to this insan. Min kulli ma sa'altumu, and then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala continues saying, wa in ta'uddu ni'mat Allah, if this insan to try to enumerate, to try to count the mercy and the bounties and the favors of Allah, this insan would never be able to do that. If you turn the oceans, my dear respected brothers, turn the seven oceans into ink, turn all the trees and the branch, all the trees of this world, and not only that, another seven oceans into ink, and you try to write and count the bounties and the favors of Allah, this insan, the oceans will expire, the pens will get finished, my dear respected brothers, but we will not be able to write and count the favors and the bounties of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala complains, my dear respected brothers. Allah complains, innal insan, after I've given insan each and everything, innal insan ladhalumun kaffar, that this insan has come to such a level that they're in a state of great ingratitude towards the favors and the bounties of Allah. How are we in gratitude to Allah? How are we in gratitude to Allah when our days, my dear respected brothers, is spent in haram, in disobeying the commands of Allah, when our nights are spent in the disobedience of Allah, when we allow our children, when we allow our female, our wife, to leave the house naked, when we allow ourselves and our children to listen to music and listen to haram, when the muadhin is calling for Salatul Fajr, As-salatu khayran min al-naum, and this ummah is sleeping, my dear respected brothers. This is ingratitude towards Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, when we break and violate the commands of Allah. This is the greatest ingratitude towards Allah, my dear respected brothers. But Allah is waiting, my dear respected brothers. Allah is waiting. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says to insan, O insan, ya ayyuhal insan, O insan, O mankind, ma gharraka bi rabbika al-kareem, what has turned you against your Allah? What has caused you to uprise against your Allah? What has caused you to break the commands of your Allah? Fa'ayna tathabun, where are you going, insan? If you disobey the commands of Allah, where in direction you are heading? Allah cries out again, fulfill ru' in Allah. Fulfill ru' in Allah. Allah is saying, O insan, come to your Allah, come to your Allah, come to your Allah. Until when will we carry on? Until how long we're going to disobey the commands of Allah? How long we're going to miss our salah? How long we're going to let the commands of Allah go, keep on breaking and breaking and breaking, my dear respected brothers? Until when? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala introduces himself to in Quran, my dear respected brothers. And over again, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is reminding insan. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala reminding insan. First ayat of Quran, my dear respected brothers. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, Bismillahir Rahman. Allah introduces himself in the name of Rahman. And throughout Quran, Allah says, Wa rahmati wasiyat kulla shay'in. Ar-Rahman wa lal arsh istawa. Ar-Rahman allama al-Quran. Khalaqa al-insan. Over and over again, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is calling this insan to the mercy of Allah. Over and over again, my dear respected brothers, Allah is calling this insan to the mercy of Allah. Night and day, my dear respected brothers, the earth is making dua to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Oh Allah, give me permission that I like open myself, I can swallow this sinful insan, that the days are spent in haram, the nights are spent in haram. The oceans is making dua to Allah. Oh Allah, give me permission so that I can destroy this insan, this sinful insan. I can rise up in tsunamis, I can destroy them. The winds in the sky, they make it dua to Allah. Oh Allah, give me permission so that I can rise up in tornadoes and destroy this insan. Destroy this sinful insan. The nights are spent in haram. The days are spent in haram. Give me permission, my dear respected brothers. But look at the mercy of Allah. Look at the mercy of Allah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala replies, if this insan is your creation, you do as you like. But if this insan is my creation, then leave them to me. Allah is waiting when this insan will leave disobeying the commands of Allah and come upon the obedience of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, come upon the way of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, my dear respected brothers. Allah is waiting. When is this insan is going to come back to Allah, come back to Allah? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in Quran, قُلْ say to them, Rasulullah, Rasulullah say to them, Ya ibadi, my dear respected brothers, English language or any language for the matter of fact cannot do justice to translate Quran. It cannot do justice in translating this, the amount, the level of love and muhabbat that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala kept in this world, in these two words, Ya ibadi. To help us to understand, my dear respected brothers, when Allah says, Ya ibadi, it's like, for example, a mother, she got her only child, and she picked this child up, and she looked at this child, she said, yes, this is my child. The amount of love between that mother and that child, we cannot even count this, we can't even put a scale to this, my dear respected brothers, the amount of love between that child and that mother. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala loves us more than 70 times that a mother will love a child. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala say, Ya ibadi, O my beloved slaves, O my beloved slaves, Allah is calling, my dear respected brothers. To whom? To whom Allah is calling? When Allah refers, Ya ibadi, O my beloved slaves, O my beloved slaves, to whom Allah is calling, my dear respected brothers? Is Allah calling those people who fasted in the month of Ramadan and who perform Taraweeh Salah at night and the whole year is like like Ramadan? Is Allah calling those people who stand up in the dead of the night before crying before Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? Is Allah calling those people who spend their life trying to obey the commands of Allah? Is Allah calling those people who spend their life in the dhikr of Allah? No, my dear respected brothers. Allah is not calling these people. Ya ibadiya alladhina asrafu ala anfusihim. Allah is calling sinners, those people who nights and days in haram. These are the people Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is calling. What Allah want to say, my dear respected brothers? When Allah is calling these people, the sinners that spend their night and their day in the disobedience of Allah, Allah is calling out to these people. What Allah wants to say? La taqnatu min rahmatillah. Do not give up. Do not despair. Do not give up hope in the mercy of Allah. Allah is waiting, my dear respected brothers. Do not despair in the mercy of Allah. Inna Allah yaghfiru dhunuba jami'a. That Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will forgive all sins, my dear respected brothers. All sins, Allah is waiting. Fafirru ila Allah. Come back to Ya Allah. Come back to Ya Allah. How long, my dear respected brothers, are we going to carry on disobeying the commands of Allah, trampling upon the sunnah of Habib Allah, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam? How much longer, my dear respected brothers? The doors of Tawbah are always open, my dear respected brothers, always open. Look at Fir'aun. Fir'aun, such a tyrant, the worst person to walk on the face of this earth. What he made the claim that he's Allah, Ana Rabbul Alameen. The children of Bani Israel, were slaughtered. Thousands of them were slaughtered. But when Fir'aun, he saw the signs and the ayats of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Fir'aun was ready to accept Allah. But Jibreel alayhi salatu wasalam stuffed sand in the mouth of Fir'aun so that Fir'aun cannot recite kalima. For if Fir'aun, the worst person in the face of the earth, was to recite kalima, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala would have forgiven the sins of Fir'aun and give Fir'aun Jannah. Who are we? Are we like Fir'aun, my dear respected brothers? There's one man, my dear respected brothers, in the time of Umar radiallahu ta'ala an. This person, his life was spent in singing. It's haram. His life was spent singing to earn his daily bread, my dear respected brothers. But this person, this old man, he became old. His body became weak. His voice, he cannot sing to earn his daily livelihood. So this person, he's standing in Jannatul Baqi. Jannatul Baqi is the graveyard right outside of Medina. This old man, he's standing there. He cries out to his Allah. He cries out to his Allah. He says, "Oh Allah, my life was spent in your disobedience." He says, "Allah, my life was spent in your obedience. Now I have become weak. Now I have become old. Oh Allah, I have no means of providing for myself. Oh Allah, you're a provider, provide for me." Hazrat Umar radiallahu ta'ala was sitting, was sleeping in Masjid Nabawi. Umar radiallahu ta'ala had a dream. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala commanding Umar radiallahu ta'ala to go to see to that need of the slave of Allah. So immediately Umar radiallahu ta'ala, he got up and ran to Jannatul Baqi. Some ulama say he left his sandals, he left his turban, and he ran to obey the commands of Allah. And this old man, he sees Umar radiallahu ta'ala coming towards him. He became frightened, he becomes scared. Like, knowing the quality of Umar radiallahu ta'ala, he becomes frightened. So he starts stepping back. Umar says, "No. Come, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala commands me to see to your needs." Tears filling in the eyes of this old man, my dear respected brothers. His life was spent in the disobedience of Allah. But once he called to Allah, and Allah was ready, to forgive him. Allah was ready to provide for him, my dear respected brothers. Immediately, that person, he prayed to Allah. He said, "Allah, forgive me. Oh Allah, forgive me. Oh Allah, forgive me." And that person dies. Umar radiallahu ta'ala made his ghusl and made his janazah. Allah is waiting, my dear respected brothers. When is this ummah going to come back to the obedience and the command and the order of Allah? On the day of Qiyamah, my dear respected brothers, on the day of judgment, two persons will be brought to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that are destined for Jahannam. Look at the mercy of Allah. Understand the mercy of your Allah, my dear respected brothers. Two persons will be called, Allah will command them, run to the fire of Jahannam, run to the fire of Jahannam. Allah will command them, run to the fire of Jahannam. These two persons, my dear respected brothers, one of them, he will start running to the fire of Jahannam. Who will want to run to the fire of Jahannam? He started running, the other one, he stood looking backwards. Then both of them were called in front of Allah again. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala asked, "When I commanded you, why did you start running to the fire of Jahannam?" This person would answer, "Look at the mercy, understand the mercy of your Rahman, understand the mercy of your Allah." This person ran. Allah would say, "Why you start running?" He says, "Oh my Allah, my entire life was spent in your disobedience. My life was spent in your disobedience. I thought to myself that if I should obey you this one time, maybe you have mercy upon me and give me Jannah." The other person, he stood there, looking backwards. Why is he looking backwards? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala asks, why? He says, "Oh my Allah, your Rahman, I was looking backwards, hoping that the mercy of Allah will come. Both of these people are granted Jannah, my dear respected brothers. Both of them are granted Jannah. The doors of Tawbah is always open for this ummah. But when are we going to come back to Allah? Until when, my dear respected brothers? Ya ibn Adam, law balagat dunubaka anan as-sama. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala say, O children of Adam, if you sin and you continue sinning, breaking the commands of Allah, until, for example, until New York is blackened with your sin and you continue sinning, until the whole of America is blackened with your dirty sins and you continue sinning, trampling upon the orders of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and you continue sinning till your sins blacken the earth, and you still upon that, you continue sinning until your sins reach the skies. And once you turn to Allah, just once you turn to Allah and you say, Allah, forgive me, Allah. Oh Allah, forgive me, Allah. Oh Allah, forgive me. Ghafartu laka wa la ubali. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is saying that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, I will forgive you and this would not even matter to me. Allah is waiting, my dear respected brothers. When is this ummah going to come back to Allah? So make intention today, my dear respected brothers. Today will be the day that I come back to the obedience of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Barakallahu lana wa lakum fil Qur'an al-Azim wa nafa'na bil ayati wa dhikri al-Hakim. Astaghfiru innahu huwa al-Ghafuru rahim. Alhamdulillah, my dear respected brothers and elders. We should not be happy. We should not be contented with the deen that we have today. There's much more to deen, my dear respected brothers. There's much more we can do to please Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Look at the life of Sahaba radiallahu ta'ala an. Look at Hazrat Abu Bakr Siddiq. Once Aisha radiallahu ta'ala, once Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was lying on the lap of Aisha radiallahu ta'ala looking at the stars. Then Aisha radiallahu ta'ala asked, O Rasulullah, is there anyone in your ummah with as much as good deeds as these stars in the sky? Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam replied, yes, this is Umar radiallahu ta'ala. Hazrat Aisha radiallahu ta'ala got a shock. She said, what about my father? What about Abu Bakr Siddiq? Because she expected Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam to say, Hazrat Abu Bakr Siddiq radiallahu ta'ala. Then she asked, being a woman, the quality of woman, she asked, what about my father, Hazrat Abu Bakr Siddiq radiallahu ta'ala? Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, the entire good deeds of Hazrat Umar radiallahu ta'ala is equal to one deed of Hazrat Abu Bakr Siddiq radiallahu ta'ala. SubhanAllah, my dear respected brothers. Once, on one occasion, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says to Allah, O Allah, I'm pleased with Abu Bakr Siddiq radiallahu ta'ala, and you also become pleased. Immediately, ayat of Quran comes that Allah is pleased with Abu Bakr Siddiq. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, there is not one day, there's not one gate on the gates of Jannah that will not call out for Abu Bakr Siddiq to enter from that gate. But what? Look at the quality of Abu Bakr Siddiq. What he used to do out of the fear of Allah, out of the fear of standing before Allah. What he used to say? He used to say, I wish that I was a blade. He was granted Jannah. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, you're granted Jannah. But what he used to say, I wish I was a blade of grass that would be eaten up by one beast and be done with. I wish I was a hair on a mu'min so that I don't have to stand before Allah and give account. So how can we, my dear respected brothers, how can we be contented and satisfied with the deen that we have today? We can do much better, my dear respected brothers. So Allah give us tawfiq. الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونؤمن به ونتوكل عليه ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له ونشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له ونشهد أن سيدنا ونبينا ومولانا محمدا عبده ورسوله أرسله بالحق بشيرا ونذيرا صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وأصحابه وبارك وسلم تسليما كثيرا كثيرا أما بعد فيا إخواني في الله إني أوصيكم بتقوى الله والمواظبة على ذكر الله على خير الكلام كلام الله وأحسن الهدي هدي محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم وشر الأمور محدثاتها وكل محدثة بدعة وكل بدعة ضلالة وكل ضلالة في النار من أطاع الله ورسوله فقد رشد ومن يعص الله ورسوله فقد غوى ربنا اغفر لنا ولإخواننا الذين سبقونا بالإيمان ولا تجعل في قلوبنا غلا للذين آمنوا ربنا إنك رؤوف رحيم الله أمطر شابي ورضوانك على السابقين الأولين من المهاجرين والأنصار والذين اتبعوهم بإحسان إلى يوم الدين خصوصا على خلفاء الراشدين المهديين أبي بكر الصديق صاحب رسول الله في الغار رضي الله تعالى عنه عمر الفاروق قام أساس الكفار رضي الله تعالى عنه وعثمان ذي النورين كاتب الوحي والقرآن رضي الله تعالى عنه وعلي المرتضى أسد الله الجبار رضي الله تعالى عنه وعلى سيد شباب أهل الجنة الإمامين همامين أبي محمد الحسن وأبي عبد الله الحسين رضي الله تعالى عنهما وعلى أمهما سيدة النساء فاطمة الزهراء رضي الله تعالى عنها وعلى أمه المكرمين بين الناس أبي أمارة الحمزة وبفضل العباس أولئك حزب الله ألا إن حزب الله هم المفلحون اللهم ارض عنهم وعن صحابتي أجمعين خصوصا على معاوية وعن بنات النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم الطاهرات زينب ورقية وأم كلثوم وفاطمة وعن أزواجه خصوصا على خديجة وعائشة وحفصة اللهم أيد الإسلام والأنصار وذل الشرك والأشرار اللهم وفقنا لما تحب وترضى واجعل آخرتنا خيرا من الأولى اللهم انصر من نصر دين محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم وجعلنا منهم واخذل من خذل دين محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم ولا تجعلنا معهم عباد الله رحمكم الله إن الله يأمر بالعدل والإحسان وإيتاء ذي القربى وينهى عن الفحشاء والمنكر والبغي يعظكم لعلكم تذكرون اذكروا الله العلي العظيم يذكركم وادعوا يستجب لكم ولذكر الله تعالى على وأولى وعز وجل وهم وأتم وأعظم وأكبر
بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم والعصر إن الإنسان لفي خسر إلا الذين آمنوا وعملوا الصالحات وتواصوا بالحق وتواصوا بالصبر